It's time for civil disobedience in the name of fidelity to Christ. Well, I would put it this way. It's time for just simple obedience to Christ. The only way that we're going to stop this is if men of principle stand up to it.
So special.
Not people like Trump, not people like Pence. Ultimately, they're in business to try to earn a living. You have to have people who are men of principle who will stand up against this, who will do things that are not in their self-interest. People like the ones who were at the Alamo, for example. But that kind of selfless standing for liberty usually requires church help, right? It did in 1776. They talked a great deal about the Black Robe Regiment. The pastors in 1776 did not want to go back into the kind of religious persecution that they experienced, so they pushed very hard for freedom. They were fighting for their God-given liberties. They were told that by the pastors. They were read Thomas Paine's book by George Washington, the soldiers were. They knew what they were fighting for. Americans are not even fighting for the right thing. See, when we fight for the election, that's not where the fight is. That's not the center. Yeah, this is an ancillary battle. It's a secondary situation. It's the penultimate problem. It's not the ultimate problem. And so you have to have people who are going to stand on principle, who are willing to die for principle. And that's usually going to have a religious component to it. Or it's going to have cases of people who are doing this for posterity. They want to create a free country for their children. And again, that is a hallmark of a country that has been returned to God. So said about John the Baptist was that he would be to return the hearts of the fathers to their children. If you don't care about posterity, if you don't care about your kids, if you only care about yourself, you're not going to do this. If you only care about money, you're not going to do this. You have to stand up to this. And so it requires men of principle. But then there's something else that the founders knew. They understood that liberty is a blessing from God. It's not something that you can actually take. It's not going to be given back to you by the thieves, by the politicians who stole it from you. They never return it. And you're not going to get it even in your own strength. It is a blessing from God. So you need to understand how you're going to start to set up an underground organization. And one of the best ways to do that is to look at how the church operated underground for over 300 years against vicious government persecution by the Romans. Government comes in and tells people, well, you're not going to talk about this, you're not going to meet together, right? Romans did it. Leadership in Jerusalem did it to the apostles. You remember what Peter said? He said, well, Peter and the other apostles said, we have to obey God rather than men. And he could have said, and we'll leave the consequences to God. I don't really care. You can kill me, you can crucify me, cut my head off. I can die from a virus. I don't really care. Throw me into the furnace. I don't really care.